चलिए गाइस, सो योर कॉस्ट शीट हैज बीन स्टार्टेड. ओके, फर्स्ट थ्री क्वेश्चंस वी ऑल हैड डन इन आवर प्रीवियस लेक्चर. यू हैड टू बी डूइंग थ्री क्वेश्चंस फॉर होमवर्क. ओके, नाउ इन केस दैट हैज नॉट बीन डन, प्लीज इंश्योर दैट बिफोर द चैप्टर विल गेट ओवर बाय मी, ऑल दोज पर्टिकुलर क्वेश्चंस आर ऑल डन प्लीज. आई हैव मेड योर बुक इन सच अ वे दैट वेर एवर यू हैव टू बी डूइंग अ होमवर्क, सच काइंड ऑफ क्वेश्चन एग्जैक्टली कम एट द प्लेस दैट यू ऑल विल बी नोइंग. सो इफ फर्स्ट थ्री क्वेश्चन आर ओवर विच आर इन ब्लैक कलर, इफ हैव दैट यू सी अ क्वेश्चन इन ब्राउन कलर, इट इज योर ड्यूटी टू बी डूइंग इट. इन केस यू डोंट डू, ओके, इन केस यू डोंट गेट द आंसर, यू नो वे टू सर्च ऑन द वेबसाइट. ओके, सो लेट्स स्टार्ट. दिस इज क्वेश्चन नंबर सेवन प्लीज. नाउ, इलेक्ट्रॉनिक्स लिमिटेड फर्निशेज द फॉलोइंग इंफॉर्मेशन for 10,000 CTV, that's color TV tubes, manufactured during the year 2021. Now, this question is actually on what I'll tell you all in advance. There is a company that makes some particular products, like in this case, color TV tubes. They'll give you cost sheet of 1 year. They'll give you some data, whatever will happen in the next year. So, based upon data of this year, and the estimated data and estimated changes for the next year, you have to be making estimated cost sheet. Okay, so we are going to be making one actual cost sheet for 1 year and one estimated cost sheet for the next year. Okay, so furnishes you the following information for 10,000 color TV tubes manufactured during the year 2021. Materials is 90,000 rupees. Now, materials obviously mean direct materials. You can write down over here direct materials. Factory wages. Factory wages obviously will mean your direct wages. So, therefore, your direct labor. Your direct labor wages are also incurred in the factory, no? So, therefore, those are factory overheads. Now, next few things you'll have to tell me that where will each and everything come. Everybody will be saying that particular thing. Okay, everybody will be saying that. Tell me, consumable stores, I'll tell you the meaning of that. Example, there is a machine that requires some kind of power to run. We put coal and those particular things, okay, in the machine so that it can run. That is consumable stores. Or suppose some other example, it could be say phenyl and acids which are used to clean the factory floors or to clean the machines. Okay, now these are all consumable stores. Tell me as per you, one thing that I told in the last lecture, nothing should be assumed to be direct expenses unless and until told. So therefore, forget about your direct expenses. You have three other heads: factory overheads, administration related to production, third head, admin and S&D. Okay, tell me, consumable store should be coming where? Factory overheads. So write down over here, factory overheads. Okay. Factory indirect wages. Now, two things. Direct wages is a money paid to those workers who produce your product. Then what are indirect wages? Indirect wages are the money paid to those people who do not produce your product. Example, there is one guy who is sweeping the factory floors. He is indirect worker. There is one guy who is in charge of maintenance of machinery, indirect worker. There is one guy who is responsible for greasing the plant and machinery, indirect worker. These guys don't do production, but then they do the other activities within the factory. Tell me, factory indirect wages should be coming where?
Factory overheads.
Factory overheads. Okay. Then further, lighting of factory 3,500. Lighting of factory, like the tube lights and all these particular things are there in the factory. So therefore, there will be cost of it, right? So, lighting of factory will be coming where? Factory overheads. Okay, further. Defective work, cost of rectification 3000. Now, you produce some goods. For a small example, we produce, say, these pens. Okay, but then first time we produced, they were not proper. We did a quality test that are these pens proper or not. There were 20 pens that were not proper. Okay. We are reworking on them. We are doing rectification of them to bring them up to the standard. Can you say that also amounts to manufacturing only, no? We are trying to rectify those particular things. So that is also amounting to manufacture, no? So therefore, you all can write down factory overheads. Further, office and selling expenses. Tell me. This is your general administration and S&D. I guess this is the entire head itself here. Further, plant repairs. Plant is any machinery that is used in the factory, please. So, plant repairs and maintenance and depreciation 11,500. So, where will it come? Your factory overheads. Okay, further. The net selling price was 31.6 per unit and all the units were sold. Now, this is one part of the question. Okay. The other part for which I'm doing this particular question is over here. But that is one thing I'm not trying to be reading right now. Okay. That I'll read after some time. Okay. I'm trying to solve part A of the question. Prepare cost sheet for the year 2021 showing various elements of cost per unit. Okay. So, therefore, those guys have told that in this particular case. They want per unit cost also. Okay. Now, first thing. Tell me in this case, did you find raw material stock? Did you find WIP stock? Did you find finished goods stock in this question? What have you all have read? Did you get it in the question? No. So, therefore, one thing. If there is no material stock, that's okay. If there is no WIP stock, that's okay. In cost sheet, we all will not write them. Okay. But if there are no finished goods stocks, then two quantities will always be same. Tell me which two quantities? Quantity produced and quantity sold will all be same only. Okay. Tell me, what is quantity produced in this period in 2021? 10,000. So, therefore, same will become quantity sold also over here. Okay. You are doing part A for me. I am doing part B for you. Okay. So, therefore, you do something for me. I'll try to do exactly the next part, a tougher part for you all. Okay. You will give the title part A. Now, every statement that you all make in any subject, whether it is your costing or FM or accounts, okay, please give a suitable title and try to pick up the titles from the questions itself. Okay. It becomes easiest for the examiners to try to check it up. So, you all can give this particular heading. Cost sheet for the year 2021 showing various elements of cost per unit. On the next line, you all can write down quantity produced is equal to quantity sold is equal to 10,000 CTV. Now, you're just waiting for a minute, please. I'll explain you all a few things and you all can continue. Okay. Everybody knows the formats of cost sheet, okay? In first two questions, in first two lectures, that is whatever we all have done, okay? We all have not tried to mug it up. We all know the format of the cost sheet, okay? Listen. So, first thing that comes, you all are not writing, please. First thing that comes will be what? Speak fast, please.
Direct material.
Direct material. So, direct material in this particular question is directly given to you as 90,000 rupees. Quantity is given to you. Please divide by that. Quantity is 10,000 color TV tubes. Then in that case, there is direct labor that is also directly there with you all. Okay. Once you all do that, there is no direct expenses. This will start to give you prime cost. Okay. Once you all do that, the next thing that comes is add. What add? Factory overheads. So, therefore, factory overheads, I guess in this particular case, there are six items over here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. There are 5 items over here. So, therefore, you're going to be writing the name, figure in the inner column. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Once you all do that, this will start to give you your factory overheads. Now, technically, this is gross factory cost. Then you all adjust your WIP stock. You arrive at net factory cost. Am I all correct with that? Okay, but in this question, there is no WIP stock. So, therefore, this particular term, I'm directly trying to be calling as factory cost. Now, one thing. After factory cost, what comes?
Administration related
to production. But I guess that head is no longer required in this particular question. It's not even there also. Okay, so therefore, you forget that. After that, what you will get is nothing but your COP. Okay. So, factory cost will represent your COP also. But in this question, there is no finished goods stock also. So, tell me, this factory cost will represent COP, but will also now represent?
COGS.
Okay. Once you all do that, add general administration and S&D over here. Now that is directly given to in the question. There is only one single head like that. Okay, so therefore no need of the breakups as such. This will give you your cost of sales. At profit, you can start to be arriving at sales over here. Just one thing you all can try to tell me, rest you all can try to be starting. Tell me in this question, what is the selling price of the product? 31.60. Obviously, that is your selling price that comes over here. How many units you are going to be selling? 10,000. So therefore, you all multiply. This will be your sales as such. 3,16,000. And then this is going to be your balancing figure. Okay. I give you approximately 5 minutes to complete. Please start. Please finish. Neatly ensure that all your rulings, all those particular things are done, please.
Can you display the
portion? Yeah. Just a sec. Just a sec.
Thank
If anybody will get the profit, kindly let me know, please. $82,000. That's okay. That's correct. That's perfect.
Yes,
Yeah. Last 10 seconds I'm giving. Please complete. Okay. So, you're all these things are done. Okay. Listen. Your this figure was 90,000. Your this figure was 60,000. This is 9. This is 6. This is 1,50,000. This is 15. This is 45,000. This is 4.5. This is 1,95,000. This is 19.5. This particular figure is supposed to be 39,000. 39,000. So therefore, this is 3.9. This is 2,34,000. This should be 23.4, and this should be 82,000. This is 8.2. Okay, listen. Now, this is all about the data of the year 2021. Now, let's see what is going to be happening in the year 2022. Now, I'm reading those three lines that I have not read before, and I'm reading part B of the question. Okay, read this. As from 1st of Jan 2022, selling price will be reduced to rupees 31 per unit. So therefore, it was 31.6. Now we make it as 31. Okay, we are bringing down the price. It is estimated that production could be increased in 2022 by 50% due to spare capacity. Tell me one thing, in 2021, how many units we all had produced? 10,000. Now you're going to be producing 50% more. So therefore, you're going to be producing how much in this year? 15,000. Okay, this 15,000 number you'll be getting once more in part B also. Okay. Due to spare capacity. Underline this line, please. Rates for material and labor will be increasing by 10%. Please underline this line. Part B of the question now. Prepare an estimated cost and profit for the year 2022, okay, assuming that 15,000 units will be produced and sold during the year, okay, and factory overheads will be recovered as a percentage of direct wages, and office and selling expenses will be recovered as a percentage of works cost. Now, underline these lines also. So, what these guys are saying, prepare estimated cost sheet for the year 2022. So, estimated cost sheet. So, obviously, till now only year 2021 is over. 2022 is yet to be beginning. But then you have few changes for it. Okay, first change in this case, rates for material and labor will be increasing by 10%. That's it. Second part, in this case, you're going to be producing and selling 15,000 units. And then these particular two lines that we'll have to try to crack after some time. Okay, so let's start off with part B of the question. Prepare estimated cost and profit for the year 2022. Okay, so let's do that. You all write down please part B. You all can do that on the next side also, or that's okay if you have around half a side over here, that's fine. Write down estimated cost sheet for the year 2022. Just manipulating the words a bit. Quantity to be produced and sold. color TV tubes. Total per unit. direct material, direct labor, prime cost, add factory overheads, factory cost. This will be your COP, this will be your COGS also. Add administration slash S&D or general administration, you can be slightly more clear. Add profit, get sales. Is this much done?
Yes.
Okay, listen. I'm writing the easiest one, I guess. As from 1st of Jan, selling price is reduced to 31 per unit. So write down over here 31. Obviously, take your calci. Please multiply by 15,000 units. Tell me the answer, please. My calci is gone somewhere. 4,65,000. Okay, now see. Now, after this, whatever you're going to be trying in pencil. Okay, because I am 99% sure that everything will not be correct. Okay. You're going to be reading all those lines that I'm underlining right now. Okay, and only read that much. The other things as such you will not require. Listen. One, you're going to be cracking up with this line. Rates for material and wages will be increasing by 10%. So keep that line in mind. Further, factory overheads will be recovered as a percentage of direct wages. Second line. And the third line over here, office and selling expense will be recovered as a percentage of works cost. So first line, second line, and third line. These three lines will be helping you to complete your entire cost sheet. But you got to be keeping your earlier cost sheet also with you, because all these changes are in reference to whatever happened in the last year. So keep on seeing this cost sheet and keep on reading those three lines till the time you reach over here and you all try to tell me the profit. Great work if you can get it correct. I only want the profit from you. And everything that will be written now will be written in pencil only. Everything. Okay. You have got 5 minutes to be doing this particular thing. Obviously, I'm going to be explaining. But first thing, if you all can do, that'll be a lot good for you. 5 minutes, start now. I only want the profit and nothing else. Do not confirm the individual numbers, please. With me, please. Yeah, I'm showing the question now. Clock is ticking. Ensure that you all complete the things in the next 4 minutes, please. एक नहीं बेटा, हाँ करेक्ट, now you all will start. Now see, first thing, rates for direct material and direct wages will increase by 10%. Now I just want to be knowing what you all have done. Now it'll be increasing by 10%. Tell me, have you increased 90,000 by 10% or 9 by 10%? Somebody might say we have increased both only by 10%. Obviously that cannot be correct, because if you increase this by 10%, then over here what you will be writing is 99,000. 99,000 divided by 15,000 will give you some answer. Okay, this is one option. The other option is, sir, this is 9 rupees over here, sir. 9 rupees over here, we'll increase it by 10%. So therefore this will become 9.9. But then 9.9 you'll multiply by 15,000. You'll be getting some different answer over here. Okay, so obviously you cannot copy both. Okay, tell me, what have you increased by 10%? Per unit figure or total figure?
Per unit figure.
Can I ask the reason why? Okay. Suppose if I cut down that particular word, material and wages will increase by 10%. Okay. If suppose this will be the case, then just asking to that person who replied. Will you increase per unit figure by 10% or will you increase the total figure by 10% in that case? Correct. So that should not be coming away. So as per you, we should increase the per unit figure, correct?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Last time, again, why? You give me some better reason based upon whatever we all have done in last two lectures. Some better reason. Forget. Now, suppose for a small example, now say that your book is there. Okay. Now, this book approximately cost me, say, 2000 rupees to print for one book. Okay. Now, Last year, it costed me, say, 2,000 rupees per book, okay, to print up and so on, or for the printing, for binding up and so on, okay. Now, just listen to me. Last year, it costed me rupees 2,000, okay. Last year, approximately, in CA Inter for costing across India, including all the pen drives and all that we all sell, we all sold around, say, 3,000 copies, okay. So, therefore, this must have been my printing cost. Okay, this must have been my printing cost. Now, this year, my publisher tells me that each book I will sell you not for 2000, I will sell you for 2200. Okay. Now, obviously, 2200. Can we say my book cost has increased by 10%? No? Correct, no? Okay. But obviously, my total cost increase will now depend upon one more thing, and that is nothing but, in this particular case, number of students. If this year I have 4,000 students, then you multiply, this will be my cost. You all will understand that this will be 10% rise. This will be not more than 10%. It will be much more than 10%, because even the effect of the students will start to come over here. If you'll start to be thinking, no, direct material will increase by 10%, or rates for direct material will increase by 10%. Whenever they tell you any changes in material, okay, you should always remember, this material is direct material. I defined direct material as the first thing for your syllabus. What is direct material? What is direct cost? It is that cost which is fully variable to the number of units that you all produce. Now, I'm asking you one very simple thing. Suppose this line was not even there also. This line was not even there. Okay? Just try to be thinking, this line was not printed in the question. Now tell me one thing. Will you copy 90,000 from the previous cost sheet, or will you copy 9 from the last cost sheet? You tell me that first.
9.
If nothing is told, can we say, if last year my book printing cost was 2,000 rupees per student, okay, this year also it will be remaining rupees 2,000 only. Boss, this is direct material. Direct material means it is directly incurred for making the product. So, therefore, these are originally per unit cost only, okay. To arrive at the total cost, you multiply by number of units. You understood this line that I spoke? You understood this line? This cost is direct material. Direct material means it is directly incurred for each and every unit that you produce. So, therefore, if last year I was spending 9 rupees for making one unit, this cost originally is not 90,000. This cost originally is 9 per unit, and you produce 10,000. Therefore, the cost has become 90,000. Okay. Now, next year, if nothing is told, obviously, I'll be copying 9 over here, but 9 I'll be multiplying by 15,000. Beta, these are direct costs. Direct costs, by their definition, are directly incurred for each and every unit. Means, these are originally per unit costs. Now, I'm all done with the things. Tell me the final thing. Should I increase total figure by 10%, should I increase per unit figure by 10%?
Per unit.
Originally, these are all per unit costs. Some need not tell me, boss, it is direct material, directly incurred for every unit. So, therefore, you try to do the changes on per unit basis. So, even if that rate word was not given and only this particular line was there, material and direct wages will increase by 10%. Okay. We would have still done the same particular thing only. So, therefore, you write down over here 9.9. Please multiply by 15,000. You can tell me the answer. 148,500. Okay, further in this particular case, direct wages will increase by 10%. I'm asking you all, should I copy 60,000 plus 10%, or should I copy 6 plus 10%? 6 plus 10%. Obviously, and the reason is very simple, these are direct labor costs. If it is direct labor, you, in this case, it is a per unit cost, 6.6. Please multiply by 15,000, I want the answer. 99,000, 247,500, 6.5, 16.5. further. Now, factory overheads, you all write on working note number one. You're going to be doing that. Now, in all the subjects, always try this particular thing that either all the notes are there in the beginning of the question or all the notes are there at the end of the question. Okay, they're not scattered at different places, please. Okay, so working note one, factory overheads. Now, those people have got the correct answer and I have told it, it is a correct answer. Those people might not reply. But based upon this line, factory overheads will be recovered as a percentage of direct wages. Read this line 5 times and try just once more. I give you a minute. You give me factory overheads. Those people who have got the final correct answer, please don't reply. Correct. Now see, I'm telling you all by 3 ways. Whatever you might have done, you will be coming across the same particular answer. See, factory overheads will be recovered as a percentage of direct wages. Okay, so factory overheads over here are recovered, means charged, as a percentage of direct labor cost. So therefore, this has got some percentage relationship with direct labor. Okay, this has got some percentage relationship with this. Now, what is that percentage relationship? I obviously don't know because I require 2 numbers for it. So therefore, that relationship I will not be coming to know from here. Okay, then from where can I know? From my previous cost sheet. I have factory overheads which are related to direct labor. So I want to be finding out this percentage because that is whatever Sam says. Factory overheads will be recovered as a percentage of direct wages. So therefore, some percentage of direct labor is factory overheads. So I want to be finding out what percentage of factory overheads is direct labor. Okay, you all are not writing. Listen to me. So therefore, 2021 first, percentage of factory overheads to direct labor is equal to this particular figure will be 45,000 divided by 60,000 into 100. So therefore, this will be coming to 75% of direct labor. So factory overheads is 75% of direct labor. Now, in 2022 also, factory overheads to direct labor will be remaining what percentage? 75%. But in 2022, tell me, direct labor cost has become how much? Direct labor cost in 2022 has become how much? 99,000. So therefore, 75% of 99,000 in this particular case will be giving you 74,250. In case you want to be doing, that's the first way. I don't want to be doing like this. Okay, second way. Now, what those guys are trying to be saying, factory overheads are related to wages. Okay. So, if any change will happen in wages, same changes will happen in factory overheads also because factory overheads is related to wages. So, now my second method. Simply, I am doing this particular thing. In 2021, this was 60,000. This was 45,000. In 2022, if this has become 99,000, this figure would have become how much? 74,250. Okay, you want to be doing like this? I'm all okay with it. Third method, I'm not writing. I'll tell you all already. That'll be far better. If factory overheads is recovered as a percentage of direct wages, means it is related to direct wages. If it is related to direct wages, whatever will happen to direct wages will happen to factory overheads also. Tell me, what happened to direct wages in this year, in 2022? Tell me, what happened to direct labor? It increased by 10% on per unit basis. Okay. So therefore, even factory overheads will increase by 10% on per unit basis. Pick up your calci. 4.5. Factory overheads was 4.5. Add 10% to it. Tell me the new figure. 4.95. You pick up your calci. 4.95 into 15,000, please do. That'll be giving you 74,250. Okay. You do by any way, answer is going to be same only. Okay. I'm leaving you all with two methods. You can write on both the methods for factory overheads. Okay. And this will be your working note one over here. Okay. Write on, please. You write on this number first. Give the reference of working note number one. Get me this way. You copy down this working note, please.
Saying it will be recovered, then why is it increasing in the next year?
Because direct wages is increasing, no? If direct wages will increase, it'll be recovered, means it'll be charged, beta. You will incur it based upon that, okay? You incur cost, okay, but ultimately you recover it from your revenues, no? So that is just a way of seeing the things, okay? Once it is done, please reach till factory cost, everybody. Okay, so this figure is how much, beta? 21.45, and total figure is how much?
321750.
Okay. One last thing that's left, and that is whatever will finish up the question also. Write down working note number two. General admin / S&D. Working note number two. What is given about this? Almost the same words here. Office and selling expenses, that is what we want, is recovered as a percentage of works cost. Okay, now works cost is an alternate name for factory cost. Recall your first lecture on cost sheet. Factory cost or has four names: factory cost, works cost, manufacturing cost, production cost. Okay, so therefore your admin and S&D are related to, in this case, your works cost. Okay, now I'm not going to be doing by both the methods. You can tell me first method or second method. So anything is okay, answer in any case is going to be same only. So first or second?
Second.
Second. Okay, so you all can write down over here works cost, and this will be general administration / S&D. So, I guess this figure in the last cost sheet was 1,95,000. This figure was 39,000 in 2021. In 2022, this new figure has become 321,750. Please get this figure, put this in your cost sheet and get your profit as a balancing figure, please. Finish it off. Now, what I have done in this question, direct material and direct labor will remain same per unit by default. Obviously, if this line was not there, okay, I would have copied that 9 rupees and 6 rupees. This line was there, so therefore I increase them on per unit basis. Second, for overhead, something will be given for sure, like in this question for factory and office and admin, something will be given for sure. Okay, please follow the instructions. We exactly did the same particular thing only. Okay, now, this is altogether done. Question number 7 is all done from my side. 8th, you all can leave 2 sides. But this question, no, try to do once your chapter is over, because one adjustment that will be coming towards the end in this particular question, I'll require one question that will be done towards the end. Okay, so leave 2 sides, please. Question number 9. Nice question. Read. A Limited company has a capacity to produce 1 lakh units of a product every month. So that's our capacity. We all can be doing that particular thing. Okay. Its works cost at various levels. Works cost means factory cost. So now those guys are not giving you direct material, direct labor, direct expenses, factory overheads. They are directly starting away with the information of factory cost. Its works cost at various levels of production are as under. Now, level in percentage 10%. Now, 10% obviously means 10% of 1 lakh. Means if you are going to be producing 10,000 units per month. Okay. This is per month capacity. Hence, I told per month. So, if you are going to be producing 10,000 units per month, your works cost in this particular case is going to be 400. Okay. If you are going to be producing at 20%, means 20,000 units per month, your works cost per unit will be falling down to 390. If you are going to be producing 30,000 units, that is 30%, so your works cost will further fall. Likewise, there are 10 levels which are given to you. So therefore, you can either work at 10%, 20%, 30, 40, likewise till 100. Okay. Your works cost in each case keeps on falling. Its fixed administration expenses amount to 1,50,000 and fixed marketing expenses amount to 2.5 lakh rupees per month. Okay. Respectively. The variable distribution cost amounts to 30 per unit. It can market 100% of its output at 500 per unit, provided it incurs the following further expenses. Okay. What those guys are saying, it can market. Market means it can sell. It can sell 100% of its output at 500 per unit. So, therefore, we can produce and sell at 100%. Tell me, 100% means how many units per month? 1 lakh. So, we all can produce and sell 1 lakh units per month at 500 rupees of selling price, provided we incur the following further expenses. Now, which further expenses? A. It gives gift items costing rupees 30 per unit of sale. Okay. B. It has lucky draws every month, giving the first prize of 50, second prize of 25, third prize of 10,000 and 3 consolation prizes of 5,000 each to the customers buying the product. Okay. See, it spends 1 lakh rupees on refreshments served every month to its customers. D. It sponsors a television program every week at a cost of 20 lakhs per month. So, therefore, this is one information. Okay, so we all can sell 1 lakh units per month provided we incur A, B, C and D. Further, what is given? It can market 30% of its output at 550 per unit without incurring any of the expenses referred to in A to D above. So, what those guys are saying that if we want to only sell till 30% of our output, okay, means 30% means 30,000 units per month. We can sell it off at what rate here? 550. Without incurring all these particular expenses from A to D. Okay. Advise the company on the course of its action. Show the supporting cost sheets. Okay. Now, you are never ever going to be reading whatever is printed below. That is my job, okay, that I would like to be reading once it is done. Okay, don't spoil your mind by doing that. Please control your anxiety, okay. You all can keep a paper over there up and so on. All those things are there for your revisions. Those things are not to be read when we are reading the question for the first time. Okay, now see. In this question, no, we all have 10 levels to be deciding. Okay, should we operate at 10,000 or 20,000 or 30,000? That goes up till 1 lakh. We have to be deciding the best course of action. Okay, now see. Now, suppose. Listen very carefully. Suppose we all have a lot of time for solving this entire question. Okay, so what I should be trying to do? I should be trying to be making 10 cost sheets. There are no stocks in this particular question, please. Okay. So, therefore, what I should try to be doing? I should try to be making, in this particular case, 10 cost sheets like this. Okay. So, therefore, let's produce and sell at 10,000. Let's produce and sell at 20,000. Let's produce and sell at 30, 40. This goes up till 1 lakh. Okay. Just imagine that I have made the 10 cost sheets. Okay. In that also, I have a total column, per unit column, total column, the per unit column, the total column, the per unit column, so on and so forth for each of my 10 cost sheets. Okay, I'll do them in a columnar manner. Okay. Now, I have made all the cost sheets. Okay, I have made all the cost sheets. You have to be selecting which is your best cost sheet. Means, that is whatever those guys had asked me. Advise the company on the course of its action. Show the supporting cost sheets. So, therefore, those guys are asking you all what should be done. Tell me what should be done. Which out of the 10 cost sheets will be best? I'm giving you all 6 options. You select whatever is the best one. See, when you're going to be making the cost sheet, you will arrive at your total cost. You will arrive at your profit. Okay. You will arrive at your sales. Okay. I'm giving you all 6 options. Tell me which course of action is best for any company in this world first. Sir, that course of action is best wherever sales is highest. Somebody says, no, sir. Sales, no, sir. Okay, that course of action is best wherever selling price is highest. That is the per unit figure. This is first option. Sir, nonsense. That option is best wherever total profit of the company is highest. Okay, total profit means this particular figure. Somebody can be again saying, sir, nonsense. That option is the best option wherever per unit profit is the highest. Okay, so therefore profit per unit is the highest. Okay. Next, sir, you have said all utter nonsense till now. Sir, that option is best wherever total cost is least, sir. Nay, sir, that option is the best wherever cost per unit is the least. Now, what I am trying to ask you all is that how do I select my best option? Should I select it based upon total? Should I select it based upon the per unit? And what is aim of every company? Like, you know, to have higher sales, least cost or highest profit, you all try to tell me. Example, why I'm asking you this, suppose it might happen that cost per unit is least over here. Okay, cost per unit is least over here in this 10th cost sheet. But profit per unit is highest in this particular cost sheet. Okay. So, therefore, which cost sheet is better? So, you tell me a company wants what in life? Higher sales or highest selling price or higher total profit or higher profit per unit or least cost overall or least cost per unit? Tell me if suppose you are a businessman, you are doing a business out of these 6 things. What do you want in life? Tell me only one, please. Tell me only one. Tell me. Okay. You can tell me 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. That'll be far better. If you're going to be getting this thing wrong, no. Okay. Just an instruction. Do not do business in life. Okay. Do articleship. Do job. That is far better. Don't do a business in life because you'll be very pathetic in that. Okay. So, as a businessman, what do I look for? So, somebody has told me least cost per unit. Okay. I want highest sales. Okay.
4, 5, sir.
Least cost per unit. Somebody told highest profit also. Okay. Somebody for 2. I want highest selling price in life, sir. Okay. Somebody for total highest profit. Somebody for total highest profit. Okay.
Total cost.
Obviously, in life, no. Every company and everybody in this particular world only wants this particular thing. That is point number 3. Rest is all nonsense. Okay. You should try in this case to do the other things. But what ultimately matters is total profit only. Now, example. Say Jeff Bezos. Okay. Who is Jeff Bezos? Who is Jeff Bezos?
The founder of Amazon.
Okay. The founder of Amazon. Okay. And the CEO of that. Okay. Obviously, when he sells a product, his cost might be super high. We are not interested in that. His selling price might be very less. We are not interested in that. Okay. What you take home in life is always your profit, no? Example. If somebody told me this, sir, I want very high sales, sir. Okay. You can try to do very high sales. But if your cost is more than that, will you be happy? No. Okay. Same way. Sir, I want very low cost, sir. Okay. Then don't run your business, no? Your cost will become zero, no, in life. Correct, no? You don't run your business only, so it will become zero. So, will that particular thing to make you happy? No. Okay. Now, example, Apple every year when it is launching the phones, no. In fact, its cost is increasing. Okay. Its cost is increasing, but it is okay because ultimately they all increase the selling price also. And then ultimately they all increase profit. Boss, aim of every company is always to be having highest profit. Profit per unit, all these things are nonsense things. Okay. If you reduce your selling price, can we say your profit per unit will fall? I'm asking you all, if you all reduce the selling price, can we say your profit per unit will fall? Yes. But if the volumes will increase and your total profit will increase, that is far better, no? Example. If I keep the fees of say one subject as 20,000 rupees, okay? Out of 20,000, say 5,000 rupees is my cost. So therefore, profit per unit that I make is say 15,000 rupees. Okay. So therefore, this is profit per unit. Okay. Say that I'll be getting 100 students. So therefore, this is going to be my profit. Okay. Now, this is one option. I thought I'll cut down the fees to 12,000. Okay. My cost will still be remaining 5,000 only. The profit per unit in this particular case will be falling down to 7,000. But if I can have 1,000 students, ultimately, I will be more happy, no? Beta, to spend in life, you require money, no? Money only means absolute profits, no? What you take home is money, no, in life. So, all those things, no, that you might learn in future, okay, profit per unit, profit percentage to sales, all those things are all nonsense things, okay. Everybody in life only craves for one thing, and that is highest total profit. Repeat that. Every company only wants highest
total profit.
Obviously, wherever you will be getting highest total profit, that particular option is going to be the best option. Example, in say on 15th of August 2021, you all will be knowing that particular thing. Ola launched its electric scooters. Okay. Now, when they launched the electric scooters, they did not price it very high. Okay. Obviously, their selling prices will not be that high. Common sense, profit per units will not be very high.
But boss, those guys did 5 lakh bookings on the first day. Okay, automatically the volumes will be so high that total profit is going to be very high, no?
Yes, sir.
Okay, that's common sense, yaar. Okay, what we all want is highest total profit. Apne ko paisa mangta hai. Paisa matlab total money that you are going to be taking home. Okay, so therefore, in this case, if I'm going to be making 10 cost sheets, if I'm going to be making 10 cost sheets, out of those 10 cost sheets, last time I'm asking you all, which cost sheet will be regarded as the best cost sheet?
The
one which has total highest profit. Okay. Now, one other thing. If you'll remember the other day, I told you all, per unit column is only made when there are stocks, no as such. Else, I do not require per unit column in any case. Is that all okay? In this question, there are no stocks. So why the hell I'm trying to be making a per unit column? In any case, my decision is going to be based upon my total profit. So therefore, what I'm planning to do now, I'm planning to be making 10 cost sheets. Okay. So I'll be making 10 cost sheets, one at 10%, one at 20%, one at 30%. Okay. One at 40% and so on and so forth. And wherever my total profit is highest, that is going to be the best option. Okay. Now, in this question, there are no stocks. Okay. You all realize that when you all read the question also, there are no stocks as such. Okay. Now, listen to me very carefully. If there are no stocks, listen to me very carefully. Format of cost sheet is useless. Now, format of cost sheet only matters if there are stocks. No. Example. This was a cost sheet that I taught you all. Just a sec. This was a cost sheet that I taught you all, right, on the first day. Now, just imagine one small thing. That if suppose, there are stocks, there is a stock over here, there is a stock over here. If I put direct labor, if I change the position of direct labor from here till here, can we say my valuation of WIP in finished goods stock will change, no? Okay, but imagine that there are no stocks in the question. Can we say if there are no stocks in the problem only, then whether you put direct labor over here or you put direct labor over here, wherever you will put, your profit will still remain same, no? Okay, so one thing that does not matter is format of the cost sheet. It is all nonsense format if there are no stocks. Why did I tell you this? Don't waste your time in formats and all. Okay. If there are no stocks, add up all the costs, subtract from sales. You should be getting your profit. That is what you all are doing since 11th standard, no?
Yes,
okay. So forget about the title. This is this cost. This is this cost. What we will do with it? It is a cost. No, you add up all the costs, subtract from sales. You'll start to be arriving at your profits. Okay. So therefore, one thing, we are not making per unit column because there are no stocks. Format of cost sheet does not matter because there are no stocks. Okay. So simply you all are going to be doing one small thing. Add up all the cost, subtract from sales, arrive at your profit. Wherever the profit is highest, that is going to be the best option. So you all can start to be making 10 cost sheets in rough and you all can try to tell me where the profit is highest. But I will not make you all make 10 cost sheets. Sir, why 10 cost sheets we should make? No. If you'll read the question super carefully, you have to be deciding whether to operate at 10% or 20% or 30% or 40%, 50%, 60%, 70%, 80%, 90% and 100%. So therefore, these are in this case your 10 options. We have to be working out the best option out of all these options. Okay. I'm just trying to gather the data for you in a proper way. Okay. In the best possible way that I can. Now see, what is given to you in the question? Listen. Now, listen. If I'm going to be working at 10%, okay, 20% and 30%. Works cost in this particular case is going to be 400, 390, 380. 370, 360, 310. Okay, further, can we say this admin and S&D in any case will get incurred no matter which level are you talking of? That's okay. So my fixed admin in any case, no matter what level you're going to be operating, is going to be remaining as 150,000. Okay, in
all the cases, in all the cases. My fixed selling and distribution cost is going to be 2,50,000, is going to be 2,50,000. Okay, further. The variable distribution cost amounts to 30 per unit. So therefore, variable distribution cost in this particular case is 30 per unit. So therefore, this is 30, this is 30. Okay. Now, in any case, this is a common data. Now see, this is a catch. It can market 100% of its output at 500 per unit, provided it incurs the following further expenses. So in case you want to be selling up to 100%, your selling price is going to be how much? 500. And you have to incur the expenses from A to D. Okay. Now see, this line is my final line. It can market 30% of its output at 550 per unit without incurring any of the expenses referred to in A to D above. Might be ICNA should have added one more word over here. It can market up to 30%. They forgot to add that particular word, but they all interpreted as if that word was there. Means if you want to sell up to 30% means either 10% or 20% or 30%. Then in that particular case, you can sell your product at what price? Tell me.
550.
And you do not need to incur the expenses from A to D above. So therefore, if you want to operate till 30%, your selling price is going to be how much here? 550. And you will not incur A, B, C, D. Is this all okay? Whatever I have written?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes.
Now, this line, no. Now you read this line. Okay. And then something should strike you. Now see, if you want to sell only up to 30%, then you can sell the product at 550 and do not incur the expenses from A to D. But in case you want to be going beyond that, then this line is applicable. It can market, again it should be, it can market up to 100%. So it can market up to 100% of its output at 500 per unit, provided it incurs the following further expenses. Now this line, though, you read in reference to this particular line. So in case you want to be only selling up to 30%, you can sell at 550, do not incur the expenses from A to D. But in case you want to be selling beyond that, now tell me, beyond 30% is what? 40 to 100. So therefore, see, I'm trying to interpret this line in exactly opposite way. So therefore, those guys have told me that up to 30%, what is the status? So I try to be thinking, means beyond 30%, if I have to be doing, then what will happen? This particular thing will happen. So this particular thing means I will have to sell the product at what particular price?
500.
And I will have to incur the expenses from A to D. Now, what is A cost? We give gift items costing rupees 30 per unit of sale. So therefore, we incur 30 per unit of sale. Okay. Part B, we have lucky draws every month, giving first prize of 50, second prize of 25, third consolation prize of 10,000, three consolation prize of 5,000 each to the customers buying the products. Just total up all these particular things, that should be coming to 1 lakh. Please total up in your mind, please.
Yes, sir, 1 lakh.
That comes to 1 lakh for everybody. Okay, so therefore, in case you want to be doing that particular thing, then spend 1 lakh rupees on lucky draws. Adjustment number C tells you we need to be spending 1 lakh rupees on refreshments served every month. So therefore, this will be another cost. Okay, and then we have to be sponsoring some television program which will be costing 20 lakh rupees per month. Okay, so therefore, if you are going to be there up to 30%, this is the status for you. If you are going to be doing anything from 40 to 100%, this is a status for you. Is this understood for everybody?
Yes, sir.
So now I'm telling you all the final thing. I have not told you all the final thing. What I'm trying to tell you is that I will not make cost sheet at 10% and 20%. I will only make cost sheet at 30%. Sir, why so? Because, listen to me very carefully. For me, can we say that cost sheet is going to be the best cost sheet wherever you will be getting total highest profit? Is that all okay?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So try to be thinking 30% will always give you more profit as compared to 10 and 20%. Sir, why so? Because now I'm giving you three reasons, and those three reasons you'll have to be repeating once my three reasons are over. Okay, you'll have to be repeating exactly in the same manner only. First, even if profit per unit remains same at all the levels, 30% is 30,000 units, so total profit will be highest. Is that understood?
Yes, sir.
I want ultimately highest total profit. No, so therefore, even if profit per unit remains same, it is better to be operating at highest level so as to be getting highest profit. So therefore, first reason. Second reason, works cost is lowest at 30%, so therefore profit will still be higher at 30%.
Yes, sir.
Understood, no? My profit will be rising at 30%. My second reason. Okay, third. Fixed cost remaining fixed. Fixed cost remaining fixed. It is always better to operate at highest level, no?
Yes, sir.
If my rent of the class remains same only, whether I have 100 students or I have 300 students, okay, it is better to be having 300 students, no? Okay, so I'm not going to be making cost sheet at 10 and 20%. I'll be directly making cost sheet at 30%, because 30% gives me higher profit as compared to 10 and 20. If somebody does not trust me, it is all okay. You can make the cost sheet at 10 and 20% also. Automatically, in end, you'll start to be realizing, sir, 30% had to be showing higher profit. So therefore, tell me 30% means how many units per month? 30,000. So therefore, you are in this case going to be making one cost sheet at 30%. Now, exactly those three reasons, whatever I told you, will be applicable over here also. Okay. Instead of making cost sheet from 40 to 90%, 100% of course will be giving you higher profit only. Okay. Tell me those three reasons again. One, first one. Even if profit per unit remains same, can we say higher units will be giving you higher profit? No, first reason. That's okay. Okay. Second. Works cost is least over here. So therefore, if works cost is least over here, profit per unit will be highest. No, over here. So automatically your total profit will also be highest. Okay. And third reason. Fixed cost remaining fixed, and there are many fixed costs over here. Fixed cost remaining fixed. Fixed cost remaining fixed. Fixed cost remaining fixed. It is always better to be working at the highest level. Okay, so therefore, in end, I make your job the easiest and complete that easiest job in rough. You are only going to be making two cost sheets. One is at 30,000. One is at 1 lakh units. I want the total profit at this level and at this level. Wherever the profit is going to be the highest, we are going to be selecting that. Is that understood, the work that you will have to try to be doing?
Yes, sir.
Okay. I'm reading the shorts of this particular question over here. Okay. Because this part will have to be written in exams also. Okay. Now, you all can write down, you all can make a bracket over here and write down, write in exams. This is part of your answer only. Whenever there is a question where decision making is to be done, every company goes for that option wherever profit is highest. Profit always means total absolute profits. For this question, as compared to 10 and 20%, 30% will always show higher profit. Why? Even if profit per unit remains same, more units will result into higher profit. Okay. Works cost per unit is lower at 30% as compared to 10 and 20%. Fixed cost remaining fixed is better to be operating at highest level. Hence, we only make the cost sheet at 30%. For the same explanation above, as compared to 40 to 90, 100% will be showing higher profit. Therefore, we only make two cost sheets, one at 30, one at 100, and we go for that option wherever total profit is highest. Okay. My job is altogether done. You are going in rough. You are making two cost sheets, only the total. Okay. Try to get me total profit under both the cases. I will select that particular cost sheet wherever profit is highest. Okay.
I did my job for 20 minutes. You have a job for 6 minutes. Okay. Ensure that you all do. Get me both the profits, please. Your time starts now. Both the profits. And be cool. The numbers will be big. Okay. You can use your calcis. Write somewhere. That'll be far better. This thing, I don't want to show you all so that you all read the question once more. Okay. I'm showing you for 5 seconds. Time over. Now you all have the question. I have taken that data from the question itself. No, you all have got this much time left. Do it.
I want both the answers, but everybody is correct only. Till now, all the answers are correct. Let's start now, I think. I think it was only about the calculation and nothing else. But one thing. Now, you all took approximately 3 to 4 minutes. I think so. If I was in your place and I had to be doing the things in 20 seconds, no? In 20 seconds. Then I could have done like this. Okay, in case you all want to be doing it in 20 seconds. Okay, pick up your calcis and do like this. And next time you all can try to do like this in every situation like this. Selling price 550, take on your calci, minus all the per unit figures, minus 380, minus 30. How much does it come to? 140 per unit. Okay, please multiply by 30,000 units. This will give you the total amount. 42 lakhs. Subtract total 4 lakh rupees from there, you will come across your answer. So 38 lakhs. In end, I have taken care of all the cost, no, as such. Correct, no?
Yes, sir.
Okay, you could have done like this. Okay, at 100%, it will save your time to a great extent here. 500 minus 310 minus 30 minus 30. Please do it. That should be coming to 130, I guess. Into 1 lakh units. So therefore that will be coming to 130 lakhs. Minus all your fixed cost. 4 lakhs over here. 1 lakh over here. 1 lakh over here. And 20 lakh over here. Directly you will be getting 1,04,000. Okay. So you could have done the things in 20 or 30 seconds also. Vaise toh. Lekin it's okay. We all will still try to do that in the same way. The way that you all have done. Okay. So write down please. This is question number 9. Write, note, printed in textbook. So in exams, you're going to be doing that particular thing first. Okay, please, you mention this particular thing, please. And then we are starting away with the answer. Cost sheet for the month. Level 30%, level 100%, number of units 30,000, number of units 1 lakh. Works cost 30,000 into 380. Please keep on putting the numbers over here instead of the word, instead of tick. Fixed administration 1,50,000. Fixed selling expenses 2,50,000. It's fixed selling expenses, no? Just a sec. Fixed marketing, I'll write down. I'll try to have the same word, so therefore there is no confusion. Then variable distribution expenses 30 per unit into 30,000, 30 per unit into 1 lakh, and then all those extra expenses that will only be coming in 100% column. Gifts nil, 30 per unit of sale, so 30 into 1 lakh, 30 lakhs. Then you have lucky draws, I guess. Refreshments. Sponsorship 38,104,000. Company is advised to operate at 100% as it leads to highest profit. For every homework section question, please, it is printed. How many sites are to be left, please? You might not be asking me that question. Everywhere it is given over there. Once done, please do let me know. Take break for 5 minutes. We shall start after that, please. Yeah. Well, we'll start away with the next question. Question number 10. Now, unit cost sheet is generally a name given to a cost sheet whereby we just try to find out cost of one unit. Okay. That's why the name comes as unit cost sheet. Nothing else is required in this question. Now, question number 10. The cost structure of an article, the selling price of which is 45,000, is as follows. Direct material 50%, direct labor 20%, overhead 30%. So whatever is the total cost of one unit, out of that 50% is material, 20% is labor, 30% is overheads. Now, read this line, is the most important line. An increase of 15% in the cost of the materials and 25% in the cost of the labor is anticipated. So, those guys are saying material cost is about to be rising by 15%. Labor cost is about to be rising by 25%. Tell me one thing. If cost will rise and selling price will remain same, what should fall?
Profit.
The same line is given to you now. These increased costs in relation to the present selling price, beta. Present selling price is 45,000. Would cause 25% decrease in the amount of present profit per article. Okay. So, therefore, in this case, if these costs will be rising the way that it is told, material will be rising by 15% and labor cost will be rising by 25%. Your profit in this case will be falling down by 25% in relation to the present selling price. You are required to prepare a statement of profit per article at present. In any case, the question is all about one unit only. Okay. So, prepare a statement of profit per article at present. Okay. To compute revised selling price to produce same percentage of profit to sales as before. This we'll answer later. We are trying to be doing this. I'm giving you all some hints. And try to crack those hints and try to come across the answer. Now, one thing, whether you were good in maths or you were not good in maths, your CA inter and CA final does not depend upon that only. Okay. So, it's all common sense. I'm giving you all 1 minute first. You read the question in 1 minute by yourself and then I shall start. But 1 minute, please read it by yourself. So, therefore, whenever I ask you something, you all know about that. Just read the question in your mind once, please. I guess you all have read. Okay. So now I'm giving you all some hints. Okay. See, you're not copying. You are only listening. See, tell me one thing. What is the present selling price of the product? What is the current selling price of the product?
45,000.
Okay. Cost plus profit obviously gives you selling price. In this question, do not talk of number of units because number of units are not given. We are trying to do the things all for one unit of the product. Okay. Currently, the selling price is 45,000. I do not know what is my profit. Let it be X. I do not know what is my cost. Let it be X. I don't know what is my profit. You let it be Y. So, therefore, one equation is there with you. X plus Y is equal to 45,000. Tell me one thing. This cost has three parts. Tell me those three parts of the cost, please. DM, DL and overheads. Okay. So, therefore, you break up X into those three parts, whatever is given to you in the question. The total should be X. Okay. Now, further, what those guys are saying, material will be rising by this much percentage. Put that percentage over here and try to get new direct material cost. Direct labor cost will be rising by this much. Take that percentage, get new direct labor cost. Nothing is given to you about increase of overhead. So, common sense, try to think what you will be doing. That is your job. Okay. So new material, new labor, new overheads. Can we say this figure has to be far more than X, no? Because the cost is rising, no? So therefore, it will become more than X. And then what these guys are saying, these increased cost, obviously this cost will be higher than this cost. So therefore, these increased cost in relation to the present selling price, okay, would cause 25% decrease in the amount of profit per article. Okay. So what those guys are saying, if these costs will rise, that will reduce my profit by 25%. So therefore, if this was Y, this figure will be 25% lower than Y. So therefore, it will become how much?
Y minus
0.75Y. So is that okay for everybody? So 25% less is 0.75. No! The moment you will prepare this table, you will get two equations in front of your eyes. One is X plus Y is equal to 45,000 that you already have. And then this plus this is equal to 45,000. The moment you all do this, okay, it'll be all over. Okay. You solve them, get me the values of X and Y by solving the two equations in a simultaneous way. I'm giving you 5 minutes. Get me the answer, please. I am letting the question remain in front of you. I'm showing you all this thing once in case you all want to be seeing something. I'm showing you all the question now. Get me the values of X and Y. 5 minutes start now. Anybody with the answer, kindly do let me know, please. Job over, you should have got the answer by now. I'm starting, your time is over. Okay, so let's define X, let's define Y. And then I guess we all can continue. Write down, please. Let present cost. Let present cost per article be X. Let present profit per article be Y. Present change new. So direct material, direct labor, overheads, total cost, add profit will be giving you all the selling price. So, current selling price is 45,000. This is X, this is Y. Tell me, out of X, how much is material cost? Out of X, how much is material cost? 50%. So, therefore, what I should write over here?
0.5X.
This will become 0.2X. This will become 0.3X. Now, material cost is rising by 15%. Direct labor is rising by 25%. Tell me, for overheads, nothing is given, no. So then, what does it mean if no change is given means?
Oh.
It will remain same only, no, then? Okay. Now, present profit will be falling down by 25%. So, in case you are weak in maths, please take your calcis. 0.5 plus 15% will be giving you 0.575x. Take on your calci 0.2 plus 25%, so therefore that will give you 0.25x, 0.3x, and this falls down by 25%. Job done. This total comes to how much? Your total of these particular things, please. 1.125x. So I guess my two equations are there in front of my eyes. X plus y is equal to 45,000. 1.125x plus 0.75y is equal to 45,000. I'm trying to cancel off y. So I'll multiply first equation by 0.75. Second equation, I'm letting it remain like that only, please. So therefore, first equation will now become 0.75x plus 0.75y. Please use your calci. 45,000 into 0.75 is how much? 33,750 or what? 33,750. This will be 1.125x plus 0.75y is equal to 45,000. So these are the two new equations. Let's solve them. The moment you're going to be solving, obviously we are going to be subtracting. We are subtracting this from this. Okay. So this data will get cancelled. Pick up your calci. 1.125 minus 0.75. That comes to beta how much?
0.375x
is equal to 11,250 divided. X will be equal to 30,000. We put 30,000 over here, so y will be 15,000. 45,000 minus 30,000. Part A. Statement of profit per article at present. So, statement of profit. Statement of profit per article at present. Now, beta, this statement that you all have made, okay. Just you convert it into a rupees figure. This is your present statement only. So, just convert it into a rupees figure, okay. So, that's what I'm trying to be doing right now, direct material. So, 0.5x, can you say that'll make it that as 15,000, no? Correct, no? But everybody please start to reply. 0.5x means 15,000, no?
Yes, sir.
Okay, further, direct labor. Direct labor in this case is 0.2x. So therefore, that will make that as 6,000. Overheads. 0.3x, that is 9,000. Total cost 30,000. That is your x figure. Plus profit, that is your y figure, selling price 45,000. Okay, now listen. Now before I read part 2, I'll give you some intro, that'll be far better. Pick up your calci. Tell me how much will be 1.125x, please. 1.125x. Tell me its value. 33750. So can we say 0.75y will be 11250, no? Okay. Obviously, if your cost is rising, your profit is going to be falling over here. It was earlier, that was 15,000. They'll fall down to 11,250. So, increased cost will start to reduce your profit. Okay, so, part 2 comes. To compute revised selling price. So, they want to be changing the selling price now. Not 45,000, they want to be changing it. Okay. To produce same percentage of profit to sales as before, they want their selling price to be changed, okay, in such a manner that they get same percentage to profit, they get same profit percentage to sales as before. Okay, what I will do now, listen. First, let me calculate this particular thing. I'll give the title and then I'll continue. Write down, calculation of revised selling price. Now, so obviously your cost is changing. So in this case, I'm writing over here, revised cost is equal to 1.125x is equal to 1.125 into 30,000. Is equal to 33750. Now they want new profit also, so therefore add revised profit will give you revised selling price. अच्छा देखो, what these guys want to be doing, they want to be revising their selling price. So therefore, you got to be finding out new selling price. Now, cost is there with me. Okay, I want to be finding out new selling price. So obviously, I got to be finding out new profit also. What these guys are saying for the profit part now, to produce same percentage of profit to sales as before. Okay, they want same percentage of profit to sales as before. Now look over here. This is before wala situation. Okay, this is before situation. Now, can I tell you that profit as a percentage of sales was 1/3 of selling price? Is that okay for everybody?
Yes.
Okay, whether you say it is 1/3 of selling price or you say it is 33.33%, mathematically both these things are same. Everybody knows that. So, wherever exact percentage does not come, no, in my entire costing, you will see that particular thing. I'll try to use a fractional data. That'll be easier for me. So, therefore, what these guys are saying, you change this particular profit so that it gives you the same percentage of profit to sales as before. So, percentage of profit to sales before was nothing but 1/3. Can we say here also, now you want 1/3, no? Is that all okay? Okay, but now I'm telling you all something different. You all will understand now directly. Can we say maintaining 1/3 of selling price is exactly same as maintaining half of cost? Are 15,000 upon 45,000 is nothing but 1/3, no? So 15,000 upon 30,000 is nothing but half, no? Beta, 1/3 of selling price is equal to half of cost, no yaar? Okay. Can we say now also we want to be maintaining 1/3 of selling price? Can we say 1/3 of selling price if you want to be maintaining, you'll have to maintain, speak further. Half of cost. So therefore, I want to be keeping this particular thing as half of cost. So pick up your calcis. 33,750 into half. We'll be giving you all how much? 16,875. Can we say the moment I write down 16,875, I guess I get 50625 over here, and needless for me to be saying this upon this is nothing but one third. No. Okay, that is what you all wanted to be doing. So therefore, I'm writing revised percentage. It is revised profit. It is one third of selling price. That is nothing but half of cost. Okay, so I want to be maintaining half of cost. That comes to 16,875. So therefore, it'll give you 50625. Okay, please complete. And this is one third. If somebody wants to be writing, you can. It is 15,000 upon 45,000. All done? Okay, listen. I've told two things in this particular question. Whenever cost is given and we are asked to find out the selling price, do remember cost plus profit is equal to your selling price. That is whatever we all did in part one. Whenever we have to maintain some percentage of cost, it is written half of cost. It is same as one third of selling price. So therefore, that is a common sensing. I think that you all know since your CA foundation also or your 11th, 12th. Okay, now. That's it. Your question number 10 is altogether done. 11th is almost same as this. So therefore that I've kept for homework. You can leave around 1.5 side for it. Now see. Now we are going to be ending today's session with this particular part. Okay. There are three questions that are exactly same as each other. One word will keep on changing. You have question number 12, question number 13, lookalikes of each other. And then question number 14. Something will keep on changing in every question and hence a new answer will start to be coming. Okay. Let's do question number 12. Okay. Now see, in your modules, know there is one chapter called as unit and batch costing. That is there in a module, that is there in our book also. These three questions in your module. Okay. There is actually one of them only. The other two I have tried to be putting. They are there in that particular chapter, but they are a bit related to cost sheet. Hence, I put them over here. Okay. So question number 12, we will start off with. A factory can produce 60,000 units per annum at its optimum. That's 100% capacity. The estimated cost of production is as under. Direct materials 3 per unit, direct labor 2 per unit. Indirect factory expenses means factory overheads. Fixed part 1,50,000 per annum, variable part rupees 5 per unit, semi-variable 50,000 per annum up to 50% capacity, an extra expense of 10,000 for every 25% increase in capacity or part thereof. This in end you will read around 20 times. Okay, further. The factory only produces against orders and not for its own stock. So we are not going to be producing for keeping the goods in stock. Okay, we produce only whenever there will be orders. Okay, so therefore there is no stock in this question. The production program of the factory is as indicated below and the management desires to ensure a profit of 1,00,000 rupees for the year. So therefore, we want profit of 1,00,000 rupees for the year. Okay. First 3 months, we are going to be operating at 50%. Last 9 months, we are going to be operating at 80% required. Work out the average selling price at which each unit should be quoted. Now see what I'm saying. In this entire question, no, cost is there with you. In fact, there are 5 types of cost which are given to you in the question. One is direct material, direct labor. Speak the further 3. Fixed factory overheads and variable factory overheads and semi-variable factory overheads. So therefore 5 types of expenses are there with you. Can we say even the profit is there with you? Yaar. So profit is rupees 1,00,000. So therefore all the costs are there, all the profits are there. You add it, you start to arrive at your sales. Okay. So all these things can be put in your cost sheet also. Yaar. Okay. So we always start away with cost sheet, not directly. But whenever I start with cost sheet, the first thing that I require to be doing is that I want to be finding out quantity produced or sold of this year. Now I'm giving you 3 minutes. Pick up your calcis. give me quantity produced and quantity sold. Both of them are going to be same only because there are no stocks, and that is whatever is given to you also. I want quantity produced and quantity sold, or quantity sold, whatever you all might say. 3 minutes I'm giving you. Read the question, not a very big question. We will just see. Whatever answers you all will tell me, I'm just keeping in mind. Correct answer I'll reveal in some time. First answer that somebody gave me, 43,500. Other answers, beta, everybody should start to give me their answers, please. You will have to speak.
43,500.
Okay, somebody told me 49,000 also right now. Come on, yeah, you can tell me more on answers. Somebody got 78,000. Total units produced in the entire year. 78. So obviously that's wrong only because your answer cannot be more than 60,000, no madam. 60,000 is the max capacity. Okay. One thing you have to clear, you have to give your exams. I don't have to give the exams. Okay. So you have to try to participate and try to answer all the things. If you learn the things the way that I'm trying to be doing, it'll be quite beneficial for you, not only in costing but in the other subjects. I'm not forcing myself on you all for any damn question. Okay. So I try to make you all respond. So try to participate in everything that is happening in the class, please. Okay, listen. So obviously our max capacity is 60,000, but then we are not going to be working at 100%. This is whatever is a program that is below. Based upon this line and based upon this line, we are trying to be finding out how much we are going to be producing in this year. Okay, please give the title. Quantity produced and sold for the year. Quantity produced and sold for the year. So write down on the next line, first 3 months. No, last 9 months. My capacity for the entire year at 100% is 60,000. I'm writing 60,000 two times. So, if I still talk of 100% only, in 3 months, my capacity must be this much. 60,000 to 3 by 12 into 9 by 12. Can you say this will give you your production in 3 months and 9 months, but provided you all work at 100%, no? But are you going to be working at 100% throughout?
No, sir.
No, you're going to be working at what level over here? 50% and 80%. Get both these answers, please. Total it up. 43,500. Now this is done further. Let's start to be making the cost sheet. You want to be fixing up the selling price, no? Okay, so therefore we'll make the cost sheet. You all write down cost sheet. For the year. Or instead of that, you can write down also calculation of selling price. So that's also okay. So ultimately we'll make a cost sheet only for that also. So quantity to be produced and sold 43,500 units total per unit. Direct material, direct labor, prime cost, add factory overheads. Now, there were supposed to be three expenses over there: fixed, variable, and semi-variable. Now this I'm simply calling as total cost. There is nothing else in this entire question. In fact, add profit, start to get sales. Now, whatever does not require brains in this entire question, no? Okay, that I'm trying to be completing. For that, no brains are required. Okay, so direct material is 3 per unit. Write down 3 per unit. Direct labor is 2 per unit. Write down 2 per unit. Please multiply by 43,500 and reach till prime cost, please. $2,17,500. Further, fixed is $1,50,000. Variable is 5 per unit. Pick up your calcis. 43,500 into 5, I guess, will be coming to this particular figure only. We all have done it once. If you want, you can write down the calculations over here. 43,500 into 5. I'm doing this question for two things. One, that hardly few people had told me this is quantity produced and sold. This was one reason that I was doing this particular question. Other reason is going to be this semi-variable overheads, which you will try to crack and you will try to let me know. Okay. Once we all do that, this figure divided by 43,500 will be giving us this figure, but just wait. After that, how much profit do we want in the entire year? 1 lakh. Do you all eat any lunch or something like that? Do you all eat any lunch in the lecture or before the lecture or after the lecture? Okay. I don't eat, but still I speak. No, I shout. No, so shout, boss in the class. So in this case, your profit in this case is going to be 1 lakh. Take 1 lakh divided by 43,500, please. So per unit profit will come. How much does it come? That's okay. 2.29. Okay. So, I guess only thing that is left over here is semi-variable expenses. Okay. Semi-variable expenses. Now, I'm copying pasting this cost sheet, okay, two times more, because in next two questions, no, this part will almost remain same only. Okay. This part will almost remain same. Maximum labor might change, that we will see, and semi-variable overheads might change, that we will see. Okay, that in any case I have not written to you. Now you all cannot be doing this, so obviously you will have to be making it once more, but not right now. Listen, this question is all about semi-variable overheads. It's basically two lines of raw English which you'll have to interpret. Read this semi-variable minimum 6 times. Okay. Once you read it 6 times, pick up your calcis in case it is required and start to get me the answers. Okay. I am giving you all 4 minutes. I will accept top 10 answers. Okay. In one class, I got 118 answers also of the same damn adjustment. Okay. And obviously, one of them will only be correct. 4 minutes start right now. Read these two lines. Crack up your semi-variable overheads and get me the answer. And please tell me the answer at the end of 4 minutes only. In case you get the answer, rethink.
59,000. Okay, just a sec. Okay.
68,000.
Just a sec. Okay, now speak please. So 59,000, first answer. Second, 68,000. Okay, third. 28,500. Fourth, 62,000. Okay, fifth. 70,000. Okay.
27,500.
Just a sec. 32,500. Okay. Last three spots left.
Sir, 48,250.
48,250. Last two spots left. Tell me.
120,000.
120,000. Okay. Last spot left for anybody to come into the limelight. 80,000. Finished. Okay. Spots are all finished. Now, few answers I am wondering that you should not have given to me only. This answer, this answer, this answer, this answer. Whosoever people have given. Beta, answer cannot be lesser than 50,000, no? Those guys have told you right in the question itself only. This line is there. Rupees 50,000 per annum up to 50% capacity. So, if you operate up to 50% throughout the year, okay, you will incur 50,000. So, tell me one thing. Are you at least operating up to 50% throughout the year? Yes or no? Okay, so how can answer be below 50,000? Okay, so ridiculous answers. I am rubbing them off. That's okay. You learn something from here if your answers are wrong. Okay. So left are all these particular answers. Okay. One more answer I want before I'll continue. I want one more answer. Speak a bit louder, please.
1,12,000.
Okay. I want one more answer still.
62,500.
I still want one more answer. Sorry. 70 I have already written. Something more. Cartoons. Two lines of raw English you all can't interpret. Read now again. How much? 50,500 or 60,500?
53,500.
One last answer. One spot left. Because I want one answer to start away my discussion, else I cannot start.
Sir,
59,500. I did not want that answer. So, last, ever last, final last.
60,000.
Now you are saying anything actually, whatever. You are saying the phone numbers also, I think now. Listen to me. How much?
50,750.
Okay, I rubbed out 5 answers. I've got 7 more answers. I got 17 answers till now. Super last answer. So somebody told me 1 lakh. Now you're only trying to bundle baz now. Okay, listen to me. And maximum, I don't know how all these answers have come, to be very honest. Okay. I'll try to remain with only these answers, only these two answers. Now that person who has got 62,000, okay, you should have read these words actually, or part thereof. Now I'm reading it. See, semi-variable, rupees 50,000 per annum. Okay, अप टू 50% कैपेसिटी.
ओके,
सो इफ यू आर गोइंग टू बी वर्किंग टिल 50%, यू इनकर 50,000. सो टेल मी वन थिंग, विल 50,000 रुपीज गेट इनकर्ड इन दिस ईयर?
Yes.
And so now we are on to this particular line. Extra expense of 10,000. There is no per annum word against that.
Okay.
And rupees 10,000 for every 25% increase in capacity or part thereof. I am only reading whatever is given. I cannot try to be thinking they must be meaning this. Okay. Whatever is written, I am only trying to be telling you that. So you incur 50,000 rupees if you are going to be working at 50% throughout the year. So therefore 50,000 rupees we are going to be incurring, plus you incur something extra. What is that extra? You incur 10,000 rupees whenever you want to increase your capacity by 25% or part thereof. Means whether you want to increase your capacity by 25% or any part of 25%, say 20%, 18%, say 16%, say 5%, say 2% also. You will incur 10,000 rupees extra. Okay. So tell me now, first of all, in the first 3 months, are you going to be incurring anything extra?
No, sir.
Are you increasing your capacity beyond 50%? Are you increasing your capacity by extra 25% or part thereof in the first 3 months?
No,
sir. No. So therefore, first 3 months, so nothing extra. Tell me in last 9 months, you are going from 50% to what level? 80%. But you cannot go from 50 to 80 directly, boss. That particular thing cannot happen. So therefore, you are going to be going in steps. Okay, which particular steps? First, you go from 50 to 75. You understood why? You can only increase your capacity in 25% or part thereof. So therefore, if I'll go from 50 to 75, can we say I will increase or I will incur 10,000 rupees extra?
Yes.
And then whether I go from 75 to 100 or I go from, speak further, 75 to 80, I will still incur 10,000 rupees extra. Is that all okay?
Yes, sir.
So therefore, ultimately 50,000 rupees plus 20,000 rupees extra to go from 50 to 80, my final answer is going to be 70,000. Is that all fine?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so that is what I'm trying to be writing over here. Okay, and working notes shall follow, but you all do one thing. Write down over here 70,000. Total it up. Divide by 43,500, get your total cost, get your sales. This is the final answer that you all want, this particular answer, because some had told me work out the average selling price at which each unit should be quoted, means each unit should be sold. So therefore, this is your final answer. Okay, so whatever that answer comes, do let me know. I'm making the working note till that time, please. That's okay, it doesn't make much of a difference, but it is 17.35. Just copy down this working note, please.
sir.
Okay. This is your question number 12. Question number 13 is identical to it. Whatever are the changes, I am underlining that. Okay. Akshay, whatever is your question, no, that is your question number 13, please. Okay. Now, question number 13 now. Whatever are the changes in this case, I am trying to be seeing. I have already made them bold, but I will underline also. One is the change for direct labor. Other is a change for semi-variable overheads. There is per annum also. Okay. So, that is a change. One thing. So, your number of units will be remaining same only. Maximum direct labor and semi-variable overheads can change. So, one thing that you all do. I am giving you all 2 minutes. Make this empty cost sheet, but with all the numbers that I have written. Because maximum two things can be changing. One is your direct labor, other is semi-variable. So, this much please copy super fast. Question number 12, question number 13, question number 14 are all identical as far as the numbers go. Okay, just that few things are changing now. So, what is changing? Direct labor, that has got changed. Semi-variable, that has got changed. Direct labor, I will crack. Semi-variable, you try to crack for me. Okay. In semi-variable, I have just added two letters over here per annum and it becomes a new question or a new answer. Okay. Let me do direct labor. Now see, direct labor, what is given to you? It is 2 per unit, subject to minimum of 72,000 rupees per annum. Now, what do you mean by subjected to minimum of this much per annum? Now, very simple over here. See, I'll give you some other example. Then you can try to tell me this particular thing. Suppose like, you know, we recruited a new professor. Okay. Now, in this case, no, we recruited a new professor. We usually pay on per hour basis. So, therefore, he asked me, sir, how much will you give us per hour? I told, I will give you this much per hour. He told, okay. Now, that guy, now, he started to think, like, you know, that approximately how many hours of work you will give us. I told, I'll give you a minimum, say that I'll give you a work of around 600 hours a year. He told, okay, sir. So, this much is the amount that comes over here. Okay. Now, that guy started to think, like, you know, if I'll work for 600 hours, I will get this much amount. If the work will increase to 900 hours, I will get this much amount. If the work reduces to, sorry, work increases to 600 hours, I will get this much. But then he thought that if I will work for 0 hours, how much amount will he get?
Nothing.
Nothing.
obviously that thing will always be there in mind of a worker also, that if suppose he is not given the work only, then in that particular case what will happen. So usually the companies know, they give a guaranteed amount. Suppose now any number I'm writing, say 1500 over here, okay. Now suppose that a worker in this particular case, I'll say a professor, not a worker, I'm sorry for that. Suppose 500 hours, if a professor will be getting 500 into 1500. So therefore this will be his monthly salary, that will be coming to how much, say 75,000 rupees. Okay. Now this is the amount that he is supposed to be getting in this case for 1 month. But then, like, you know, I told him approximately you will be getting 500 hours of work every month. I should not be saying here, just a sec. One, this is say yearly figure. Okay. So therefore I told him approximately you should be getting 500 hours of work every year. He told, okay sir. So 500 into 1500, that will make it 750,000. Then he asked me, sir, if you will not give me work, then I told, then you will be getting zero amount, boss, or kya? He told, no sir, you have to give me a guarantee that this much I will get for sure. I thought something and I told him, look, whatever might happen, I guarantee you that I will pay you minimum of 5 lakh rupees, no matter whatever is the workload. So that is a guaranteed amount that I will be giving to him. Okay. That's a minimum guarantee that I'll be giving to him. Now, in a certain month, you all can keep on telling me now. Sorry, in a certain year, not month, year. Suppose if he works for 600 hours, can you say 600 hours into 1500 is nothing but 9 lakhs? Tell me, how much payment I am supposed to be giving it to him? 9 lakh rupees. I had guaranteed him that I will give him minimum how much? 5 lakhs. So I am giving him much more than that, no?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so therefore I give him 9 lakhs. Okay. Suppose in a particular month, sorry, suppose in a particular year, okay, he only works in this particular case for 300 hours. So 300 hours into 1500, that will make it how much? 4,50,000. Tell me, how much I am supposed to be giving to him? 5 lakhs. In other words, can you say this figure or this figure, whatever is higher, no?
Yes, sir.
Okay. I am giving you 30 seconds. Calculate direct labor for me. 30 seconds is also too much amount of time. How much will be direct labor cost for us?
87,000,
no?
Yes, sir.
I am supposed to be paying him 2 per unit. So 43,500 into 2 will again be coming to 87,000. My guaranteed was how much? 72. Can you say I am paying much more than 72, no?
Yes, sir.
So therefore 87,000 will remain as the answer over here. So therefore you all can write down 87,000. Divided by 43,500. In any case, that will be 2 only. This will remain same, 217,500. This will be 5. Write down over here working note 1, direct labor. Wages as per production. 43,500 into 2. 87,000. Minimum wages 72,000. Do we add both of them?
Whichever is higher.
So higher is going to be 87,000. Done. Now, left is only one thing, that is semi-variable overheads. Try. This is the only word that has changed, per annum. I can only tell you one small thing. Whenever the word per annum is there, na, it makes an expense time proportionate. Means per annum means 10,000
is incurred for 1 year. Okay, it is not a flat expense like the last question. It is 10,000 for 1 year. Okay. You have got 2 minutes to answer. Now, you will not get so many thoughts as you got the first time. Now, you will be getting lesser number of thoughts. Get me the answer. This time at least try to get me the answer here.
90,000.
No.
65,000.
How much?
65.
65,000. I've given you all 1 minute extra, so 500. Sorry?
57,500.
No. Now, see, there is not much difference between the last question and this one. You are not copying, please. Okay, listen. Now, nothing much except up to 50%, 50,000 rupees you will incur. That is still the same damn story only. Now, extra expense of 10,000 rupees for increasing the capacity from 50 to 75 and 75 to 80, that will still be 20,000. But 20,000 will be per annum, means 20,000 is incurred for, continue, 12 months. Okay. So, 20,000 is incurred for 12 months. It was 10,000 per annum. So, therefore, it's 20,000 per annum. But we want to be only increasing the capacity for how many months?
9 months.
9 months. So, therefore, into 9 by 12. This will be 15,000. Answer is 65,000. You want to be doing like this? It's all okay. Some people say we don't want to be doing like this. Okay, I'll give you another way. But ultimately, it amounts to the same particular thing only. What you all can do, first 3 months, can you say first 3 months you will incur 50,000 rupees, no? But 50,000 is there for the entire year. Can we say you will be spending into 3 by 12, no? So therefore this will be 12,500, okay? Last 9 months, can we say it will come to 70,000 rupees for the entire year, no?
Yes,
sir. 50,000 per annum, 10,000 per annum, 10,000 more per annum. So, therefore, it will come to 70,000 per annum into 9 by 12. So, get me this answer, please. 52,500. You will total it up. In any case, that will be coming to 65,000. Okay. Module sometimes does like this, sometimes does like this. In any case, answer is going to be same only. You all will understand. Over here, 20,000 is part of 70,000. In any case, that is also becoming time proportionate, no?
Yes, sir.
We are doing no into 9 by 12 in any particular case. So, therefore, this is going to be your answer. Okay. So, come back to your cost sheet. Write down over here 65,000.
Get me the selling price, please. 17 point, let me know. 24. 24 na beta?
Yes, sir.
24.
Yes, sir.
Okay. And copy down this working note too, please. Yeah, yeah. Done, beta?
Yes.
Okay, listen. Our last question. This is question number 14. Again, exactly the same question. But then those two things have again changed. I have written subject to minimum of 6,000 per month. You will have to think what change. And semi-variable, there is no per annum word over here, but I have added one extra word over here for the year as a whole. You will have to seriously think what will be the change over there. In any case, other things still remain same only. So you all can copy this particular thing for the last time. Write down question number 14. Now listen. So, whenever you are going to be getting free today, you all are going to be thinking, how will this thing change your direct labor? And how will this thing change your semi-variable overheads? Okay. Whenever we start next time, we are going to be starting with this particular question only, and I'm going to be cracking both these things. You might say, sir, 6,000 per annum is 72,000. Sorry, 6,000 per month is 72,000 per annum. It is the same thing. No. Now, there is a guarantee per month and not per annum. So, therefore, you might have to go month-wise. Okay, I've given my hints to you. And for this, I'm not giving you all any hint. You've got to be reading this particular thing for the year as a whole. You can try to be thinking what will be the meaning of that. Okay. So, this question will be continuing next time. Okay. So, bye. Take care. I'll see you all next time.